Come on, Eddie. Why are you fucking?
So first of all, Ray, who's in the gym today with us?
Let me do that.
Is my boy here?
Chris Van Heerden.
It's my father.
Who else is in the gym?
Taz, my boy Taz.
Taz, what's up, Taz?
Healing right here. How you been, man?
Good. Been working hard. How you feeling?
How are you?
Get back in Boston. Hopefully, man, all this shit is over, you know.
Well, I gotta ask you a question.
Let's go.
You're a southpaw. One person you fought was Errol Spence, and now Spence is fighting Manny Pacquiao. Mm-hmm. Chris Van Heerden, what do you think of that fight?
Yeah, I like that fight. You know, it's gonna be interesting. Pacquiao at 42, man, he's a dangerous fight for anyone. He showed it, so we don't need to go into that. He's proven it, and I'm excited for that.
Who are you going for?
I'm always rooting for the man that beat me, right? For Errol Spence, because he's the one guy that beat
me. So
but I gotta be, you know, my heart is Pacquiao.
How hard does Spence hit?
I've been hit harder than Spence.
You hit harder?
Yeah, I've been hit harder than
by Spence. By heavyweights?
No, not by welterweights, you know.
So what is it about him that makes him so good? I think he has a lot of power.
I'm not saying that he's powerful, but I've been hit harder. For example, Jaron Ennis hits way harder. But what makes Spence so dangerous, he's consistent with his power punches. So it's not a one punch knockout power it's this.
Pounding.
Every punch is pounding. And that drains you, yeah.
Now, sitting to the left of us is Ray Beltran, who for maybe 10, 12 years has been sparring Manny Pacquiao. So you just heard Chris Van Heerden. He says that Errol Spence has a pounding power, consistent, very talented. What do you think of the fight, Spence and Pacquiao?
You know what? I think you can kind of count out Manny. Never. You know, Manny still have it, bro. Like, even in 40, 42, the thing is, him, one of those fighters, like, they're very special. You know, like, they're born, like, every 10, 20 years.
I say once in 75 years, like Haley's Comet. Man. Once in 75 years.
Yeah, man, like, it's like Mayweather, man. Like, those special. Guys are just fucking special, man. That's what people don't understand. They're not that, like, the traditional, typical style, the typical boxer, man. And since I met Manny back in the days, man, like, Manny was... He's been the only guy I know that they used to do, like, 12 rounds sparring, then do, like, another 8, 10 minutes. And then the bag, and then keep jumping, then go back to apartment and keep playing guitar, and then damn, bro, it's like too much energy, and that's why he's too good now, man. Like, his style is not like the typical softball. The thing is I think he knows how to work the angles, and I think it's the only fight I ever seen that the his footwork match at the same time speed with his hand speed, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
That's why he hits you from angles you don't even expect it. And he can punch. And he is so fast, you know what I mean?
Where do you rate his power, Ray?
Man, I mean, bro, he's so hard, man. It's like, to me, it's number 10, man. Like, I mean, some of the guys might say that, I don't hit the hard, but they're welterweights. But the other thing people don't understand, man, is a small welterweight. And dealing with big guys, they're not so big, you know what I mean? They can take the punch better, but his power, I mean, I feel it. Regardless of his size, man, he punch, man.
So what does Manny need to do to win? What does Spence need to do to win in this fight?
I think, to me, you know, I think Manny have a more, he have a hard time with boxers, you know what I mean? He always give him a hard time, but Spence is not really a boxer. The guy stay there, so that give Manny a chance to get
Very, you know, Spence is not... Like Spence is not rushing you to destroy you. He takes his time, boom.
But
boom,
he's there.
Boom, but he's there. And I think that's going to work in Pacquiao's favor.
Yeah, that's what
Pacquiao
I think.
So all over the place.
Yeah.
He's not going to feel that pressure, I don't think. But I'll tell you this, and this is what I've been saying to everyone. Errol Spence, being consistent with that power punching, maybe around 1, 2, 3, 4 doesn't have an effect. But come around 6, 7, 8, you realize, oh shit, like I know what he was doing. He's just been draining me.
Yeah.
And I think if he can put some pressure on Pacquiao and start landing those big body shots, those big punches early on, even though it's not a lot, but if he starts landing them, that's the only thing I think can slow Pacquiao down later rounds.
Yeah.
Because of his age and me knowing how he drains you with those power punches. But if he's not going to get on top of that early on, Pacquiao's going to win it.
Okay, so Chris is going, or saying that it's Spence, Ray saying Pacquiao. What do you say?
I'm gonna go with Pacquiao on an upset.
Why?
I just think that he stays so busy, and I still don't know about Spence after the car wreck.
He looked great with Danny.
He did.
You didn't even tell he was in a car wreck.
But I still think there's, I don't know.
There are levels too, you know what I mean?
Yeah. I think Pacquiao might just upset him. I really do. I don't know why I say that, just because he stays so busy. You look what...
because you always...
Sean Porter was a smaller guy. And look how he did against Spence.
Yeah.
I mean, he gave him some trouble. And, you know, Pacquiao's a smaller guy, but his feet are so good.
Yeah, man.
He's so fast with his feet.
And he can punch. And also, I mean, he's been the man. You know, Manny, he's not going to go nowhere if you don't really knock him out.
Yeah.
Manny has been there with big guys that can fucking punch. Yeah. He took the punches and... I mean, he's been there many times. Yeah. So
well, much respect for Manny for taking his fight, because he could have fought anyone, and we would have been like, cool, this is maybe last fight. And
42 inches.
Yeah, bro, man, like...
Young guys don't even take the big fights.
Man, that's difference about what makes Manny so great, Manny. Manny's career has been so excited, and that's what people... I told people, they ask, who's a better boxer, Mayweather or Manny? But you gotta think also... What's career is more excited? Well, who I've accomplished, I think, more in the really more exciting career is Manny. I think Manny takes a lot of more like dangerous challenges. You know? Yeah. Like,
I mean, look at it. He's got what? 8 losses? And the guy's champion still.
I think know? 7 losses.
7 losses? Yeah.
And that's
8 division champ.
Yeah.
It's hard to win one championship.
Yeah.
Let alone 2. Bro,
8 fucking division. I think he jumped like maybe few divisions. He could have been like fucking 10. I'm like,
it's true.
How you beat that, man? Like,
so
he's amazing.